He is the first two-hander to ever win a major. Finnish powerhouse Osku Kalerma. He captured that title just a few weeks ago, defeating Ryan Schaefer, Sean Rash, and fellow two-hander Jason Belmonte here in Las Vegas at the PBA World Championship. Today, Osku returns, as will Rash and Belmonte, to join Venezuela's Ildemaro Ruiz Jr. in the Power Pack Finals of the PBA Chameleon Open. Can Osku survive and claim his second title at this year's World Series of Bowling? Find out next. Crowd in Las Vegas as we get set for the PBA Chameleon Open as the World Series of Bowling rolls on here at the South Point Casino and Exhibition Hall. Rob Stone, Randy Peterson here with you as we take a look at today's four finalists. Your number four seed, Ildemaro Ruiz Jr., the second World Series final for Ruiz, who was the runner-up in last month's Bear Viper Open. The lone American on today's show, the number three seed, Sean Rash, a four-time PBA Tour titleist, making his third appearance in the finals at this year's World Series of Bowling. The number two seed, one of the most powerful bowlers on the planet, Osku Kalerma. The first two-hander in history to win a major, January's PBA World Championship, which was his second PBA Tour title. And your number one seed, another two-hander, ESPY Award winner Jason Belmonte. The Australian threw a perfect 300 game last month during the Albi division of the PBA World Championship.
Take a look at the rules for today's competition. We are back to the eliminator format. Match number one, Randy, will see all four bowlers bowl. The key, don't come in last.
Watch what the other players are doing. Make sure you're not on the bottom of the score sheet. You don't have to finish first. You don't have to have the highest score. You just have to beat one player.
It's a tricky recipe because at times you're bowling not to lose, but if you're bowling not to lose, you can say you're also bowling not to win.
I'm confused, what?
Hang with me, I'll get through it later. The native of Finland, Palermo. It gets there in a hurry and he blows up the rack.
After surviving some close calls early, including a roll-off with Jason Belmonte, Osku Kalerma became the first two-hander in history to win a major, scoring a 203-177 victory over Ryan Schaefer in last month's PBA World Championship here in Las Vegas. That tournament contested on the Scorpion oil pattern, but today's contest uses, and is named for, the Chameleon. It's a shorter pattern at 39 feet and one that Randy says is going to favor our three power players. Palermo, Sean Rash, and the man stepping up to the line right now. Your number one seed, Jason Belmonte.
Just missed it.
That was one of the fastest ringing tens I've ever seen. There was like a vortex that was kind of circling the 10 pin that just sucked the 6 pin right off the deck.
There's Ildemaro Ruiz Jr. a few weeks back, finished second at the Bear Viper Open. Left the nine pin. Don't see that often. Belmonte stepping up to take care of his spare effort in the first. Elmo and Ruiz with spares. Here's our first look at the lone American, Sean Rash.
Oh, that's textbook.
Sean Rash representing. I kind of missed the Stuart Williams techno music. You?
Yeah, we heard it a couple weeks ago at the Bear Viper Open when he won. And Rash was in that tournament as well, was playing very well, then just a slight loss of emotional control.
Along with young Ruiz, who finished second.
And Belmo kicks off the second with the strike. That two-handed style he and Palermo shared, getting more and more respect every day, but it wasn't always that way, especially when Belmo was a kid.
The coaching staff kind of sat me down and said, do you want to get good at bowling? I said, yeah. Then you have to stop that. So now bowl one-handed. And I remember bowling a few shots one-handed. Just it was dead straight down the middle. I don't even remember how many pins I knocked over, but I remember it was horrible. I knew then that bowling one-handed, not only was it not for me, it actually upset me. And there was just no way that I would ever change who I am as a bowler and who I am as a two-handed bowler.
Yes, he is. And so is this man, Oscu Palermo, trying to double up here in the second. And he gets it.
What happened there?
There's a look at Oscu's fiance, Veronica Lento, and their beautiful baby girl, Ida.
Well, and just like we've seen in the past with these eliminator matches, it moves fast the first couple of games with four players, especially with three out of four very high-powered players.
Ruiz.
He's had some interesting leaves already. Rass takes care of the single pin conversion. Ruiz to close out the second. He gets that conversion. Everybody is clean through two, including the American, Sean Rash.
The PBA Chameleon Championship is brought to you by Budweiser. Great times are waiting. Grab some Buds. By Alka-Seltzer Plus. Alka-Seltzer Plus liquid gels provide more complete cold relief than NyQuil. By Storm. Bowlers serving bowlers. Storm is the bowler's company. And by Barbasol. Start your day cool with new Arctic Chill Shaving Cream from Barbasol. Better by Barbasol. The second straight year, we are back in Las Vegas in the South Point Hotel and Casino for the World Series of Bowling. We flash back now to some of the highlights from the qualifying rounds of the PBA Chameleon Open. Oscu Palermo on fire in the six-game round of 16, especially in Game 5, where he threw a 289. Oscu entered the final round of match play tied for ninth with Ildemaro Ruiz, but moved all the way up to the number two spot and a place in today's finals. Meanwhile, Brian Valenta did his best to make today's telecast with shots like this one. His 226 in Game 6 of the round of 16 meant that Ildemaro Ruiz had to double in the 10th to make the finals. And Ildemaro comes through and advances, finishing just 11 pins ahead of Valenta to take the fourth and final spot here at the PBA Chameleon Open Finals. As for Jason Belmonte, he would average just over 236 for the 14 games of qualifying, finishing 16 pins ahead of Palermo to earn his position as the number one seed in today's tournament.
Rob Stone, Randy Peterson back here with you. It's early, but you're already noticing an advantage for...
I think the two-handers may have a slight advantage because of the power. And as long as they can stay ahead of the transition, I think they're going to be tough to beat. That power helps them create downlane reaction. And it looks like that's going to be the key in this opening match.
And there is one of those two-handers that Randy mentioned, our leader, Finland's Oscu Palermo, the winner of last month's PBA World Championship here on these very lanes.
Top of the third, Oskar with the strike.
When you have this much power, Rob, it seems like all you have to do is just kind of touch the head pin, and there's a lot of shrapnel.
Opening three bagger for him. Fellow two-handed bowler Jason Belmonte, spare strike. Here he is in the third. There's a double for Belmo. Here is Ildemaro Ruiz Jr. And being here at the World Series of Bowling, a very big deal for the 25-year-old Venezuelan.
When I made the first TV show, it was awesome. You know, it's, I don't have any word for explaining that. It's what I want to be in, and that moment is really special, you know, because we back there in Venezuela, we always see the tour like, you know, the holy grail of the bowling. It's like a being heaven.
And a strike for Ruiz here in the third. Sean Rash. Messenger, yeah!
Well, everybody's good friend. Invite a messenger over to the party, have it take care of the 10 pin, and you're a happy guy.
Life of the party, that messenger, I tell you. Rash and Belmo on another show together here at the World Series of Bowling. We've documented through the last couple months the growing rivalry between these two young stars here on the PBA Tour. Sean not even watching. Pops his head up, and a nasty offering there for Belmo.
2-8-10 left flank, got a little fast. Ball hydroplanes, never makes the corner.
On the right lane, Oskar. No.
Boy, that's the only issue you ever see with Jason Belmonte is he gets, at times he gets a little bit fast. And with that kind of rev rate, when he gets a little quick, that ball hydroplanes. But at the same token, Rob, you get too slow with that kind of rev rate and the ball breaks loose and it goes sideways. So that's why it's so extremely important to be choosing the right equipment.
Would you choose to be a two-handed bowler if you were just starting right now?
If I was reincarnated and came back as a new professional bowler, I would use no thumb.
That's right. Come on.
And two hands. I think it's the way, okay, maybe not, but I try it.
That's right, come on.
Ruiz with the double there after opening up with a pair of nine spares.
I'm not done with your two-handed question. Last year, Mika was player of the year and won $250,000 tournament of champions and made over 330,000, right? How many hands does he use? One hand.
Oh!
This delivery goes a little bit high for Oskar, gets a trip there, and that makes that spare a lot easier. Both two-handers leave six tens.
Does that tell you something?
They both went through the nose.
Jason looking for the spare here in the fifth. No.
After that quick start, back to back open frames.
And sitting at home, that probably doesn't look like that tough of a shot, but as Belmo will tell you, nothing is a gimme out here.
You know, that's another really big misconception, is that we're an easy sport. We're the toughest in the world, by far. I've played them all. I've done every other sport, and I'm not saying that I'll be brilliant at them, but I know if I hit a good shot in any other game that I play, it's going to be exactly where I want it to go, but not in bowling.
Right now, Jason Belmonte at the bottom of the heap, looking up.
Rash looking for a triple. Give him a three-bagger.
If this kid can somehow control the emotions, control his heart rate, he can do some really good stuff. He gets too amped up at times. We've seen him before where he just kind of starts to overpower things, starts to rush, gets quick. He needs to stay in the moment.
Ruiz with his third nine spare. There is Sean. Started off 7-0 on television in his career, and since then has kind of hit some struggles. We take a look at the big board here. The top three move on. Belmo the odd man out right now through five. 7-10. Nope, just make it a seven.
Well, you can go ahead and translate that, but I'll tell you what happened here. And right now, the two-handers are struggling to hit the pocket. This ball goes through the nose, and again, just a huge fortunate break to only leave the seventh in.
Belmo, after that open frame on the left lane, gets back on the strike train.
Welcome back.
Air ball. He didn't see it and didn't expect it. Rash looking for four in a row. Aha. Ruiz. As Rash stares that one down. Boy, folks are all over the place right now. This one's coming with heat.
Trying to bounce one of those out of the back of the pit. Really your only chance to make a 4-6 combination.
This one kind of spinning out of control right now. Somebody needs to maybe apply the brakes a little bit here and let everybody catch a breath. Ruiz, difficult shot coming up here in the sixth.
Great cover.
Yeah, 3-6-9-10 is not something you want to shoot a lot of.
Oscu steps right up here to begin the seventh. Last time we saw Palermo, he whiffed on the seven pin. Belmo needing to pick up 20 pins on Ruiz to move on to match two. Low man eliminated. And here is Jason Belmonte. Last three frames, open, open, strike. He was the only one to strike in the sixth. Needs a big one here.
Big four was standing there for a second, Rob. What a huge break that is to double up now. Get himself closer and back into this match. Now he pulls to within 11.
Ruiz off back-to-back spares. A wide right of target.
Well, I think the rev rates on this telecast have destroyed the soil pattern early on. The lanes are going through massive transition.
And there's a lot of bowling left to be had.
And look at how they started. And look at the middle of this game. Everybody started striking early on. And then towards the fifth and sixth frame, the players had trouble just getting a mark. I think that's due to the high rev rates that we're watching today.
Going after the 2-4-10. Poof, just missed the 10.
And he has to sit and watch Rash. And Belmo making a big jump up into third now, and it's Ruiz who's in fourth and on the verge of being eliminated. Three more frames to go.
A lot of thinking going on out there, Rob.
Maybe too much.
And, you know, again, it's a low score out. These players are really watching their opponent's shots and watching what they're doing, looking at the scoreboard. I mean, just inches away from splitting open frames.
Belmo back up on the left lane.
Big chess match going on.
Four pin in his sights, takes it down. And right next to him, it's Palermo up. Sean Rash, open frame nine spare. Here he is in the eighth. Leaves the four pin.
So close.
None of these guys.
So close.
Able to just kind of put that final stranglehold on this match and move on. Very tight right now as we close down the eighth. Ruiz. Oh, big strike for the Venezuelan. Rash. Sean's wife in attendance. There's his dad as well, Gene. Gene and Sarah with a great view of this one. And it's going to come down to the final two frames. Strike number five. That Messenger had to travel through a couple time zones.
Well, the 10 pin got hit initially, and then the Messenger came over and just made sure it went down. And that's a great way to set up the 10th frame by striking in the ninth.
Oscu buries all 10. Guys bringing it here in the ninth. A very tight one here in this eliminator format. Rash. Last three frames, open, spare, spare.
Deal. Good shot.
Sean Rash can now be potentially eliminated if Ruiz strikes here, because that would give Oscu, Belmo, and Ruiz all strikes in the ninth frame. Rash, the only one not to strike.
Didn't like it.
Now
you
can
no strike. Yeah, you're looking at an open frame here potentially.
Yeah. Now it's completely reversed.
Yeah. Ruiz, through the course of the World Series of Bowling here and the shows we've seen him, has made some big spares as his mentor and the living legend, Emleto Monacelli, watches. Rash drops the 10 pin. So, some quiet time for Ruiz to think this one over.
His only chance, in my opinion, has to convert here.
3-6, 7-10. Not when you want the open frame.
Best he can shoot now, 188. Belmonte's in the 190s. Palermo's in the 20s. Rash is in the 20s.
There's Oscu, your leader.
He's safe and moving on. Belmonte needs a mark and good count. Rash needs good count.
Belmo, your number one seed. Working off a strike to begin the 10th.
Shot man.
And Oscu Palermo jumping up from behind the curtain with a new ball.
Belmonte needs to make that 10 pin.
A test shot. See if that'll stay in the bag for Oscu. Here's Belmo trying to pick up the spare.
Now he needs 6, and he advances.
Oscu is through.
Yeah, he was almost through the back of the masking area. He threw that ball so hard. That pin deck is taking a beating back there.
Oscu, your 2 seed, and now all eyes on Ruiz as he may be done. Belmo will step up to close his effort out here in match 1.
Oh boy.
We have a possibility of a tie. Just kidding. He wins by 1.
.189, enough to move Belmo on to the next round. It's down to Ruiz and Rash. Here is Ruiz. Money strike.
Man, that was weird. Belmonte takes the plastic ball out, whiffs a head pin, and gets 6, which is just enough.
Here's Rash in the 10th, 9 or better, and he advances.
And that's enough. That gets Sean Rash through.
And Ruiz, your 4 seed is done. So Oscu with the 213 tops in match number 1. He and Sean Rash and Jason Belmonte will move on to match number 2. Belmo, your number 1 seed. The late rally and the late messenger kick. And he moves on to match number 2. Rob Stone, Randy Peterson, welcoming you back to Las Vegas and ESPN's ongoing coverage of the PBA World Series of Bowling. Today, it is the Chameleon Open coming your way from the South Point Casino. 1 down, 3 remain here in this eliminator format. Ruiz with a 187, not enough. Jason Belmonte just able to eke out a 3rd place finish with a 189. So Belmo, Oscu, and Sean Rash advance to match number 2.
Jason, one of the PBA pros to participate in last weekend's Chris Paul PBA Celebrity Invitational. Actually, he was a teammate of Chris Paul's and comedian Kevin Hart's. Belmo was on the winning team for the past 2 years with Chris Paul. And though he performed as a pro good this year, Belmo, Paul, and Hart would fall to Team Pete Weber. As Turtle, Jerry Ferrara from the hit series Entourage delivered a money strike. And Weber would seal the deal in the 10th. So Weber, Ferrara, and LA Clippers forward Blake Griffin, the All-Star, take home the trophy. And no, Paul was not happening. You heard it here first. None of these winners are going to be invited back next year. Thank you.
Wow.
That messenger fly in front of the face of the 10.
Looked like it was turbocharged coming across there. He's made a ball change from the first game. He's going to try to open the lane up a bit more.
Oskew drops all 10.
These three players, arguably the most powerful on the planet, all competing against one another here in our second match. Oh, geez. Big hop.
Rash's first effort.
Yeah, so what?
We've seen it happen before with Sean where he shuffles his feet and when that right shoe that has rubber on it, when it squeaks like that, and he's not really 100% focused, he hears it and it distracts him. That time, no squeak. But no down lane reaction either.
Right ball.
Takes two.
Don't think he liked that ball either.
Yeah, I don't know how long he's gonna stay with that. It just looked a little soft down the lane.
Open frame to start off right match two for Sean.
I need some more water.
Oskew's second effort, struck in the first. Woo! Messenger goes on the backside and just grazes, but does not knock over the 10 pin. Sean on the left lane now.
That's a different ball in that lane. And looks like he just put that other one away.
I see a lot of guys having some footing issues on that right lane.
Oh,
I saw Jason with that big hop. And Sean with the squeak. And Oskew coming over there to kind of try to smooth things over. Back-to-back Belmo jacks.
And, you know, part of the beauty of this format is Jason Belmonte barely survived. Now is going with a different game plan, moves in, goes with something a little stronger down the lane in the back part of the lane, and he's perfect through three.
Oh.
4, 6, 7, 9, 10 split. The Greek Church.
The Greek Church open for business on the left lane.
Yeah, and this one cuts right through the heart, and Oskew pays the ultimate penalty.
Seven, 10. Nope, just a seven. And that seven was thinking about dancing with gravity and going down.
That was pretty good.
Here's Oskew. Oh, I am in pain.
That was really fast.
Golly. Sean drops the seven and gives it a little something extra for its business. We're through three. Rash with an open frame in the first.
Oshku with one in the third. Belmo, your number one seed, on top. The PBA Chameleon Championship is brought to you by GEICO, saving people money on more than just car insurance. By Ebonite, bowl to win. By Jack Links, Jack Links beef jerky, feed your wild side. And by Brunswick, find your next ball at bowlwithbrunswick.com. Welcome back to our continuing coverage of the World Series of Bowling. Today, the PBA Chameleon Open. Top two move on to our title match. And Jason Belmonte in control early on, and he is up right now for his effort in the fourth. Nine spare in the first, and then a strike in the second and the third.
Creating a lot of angle right now. He's using all that power to his advantage. He's moved way in. And he's just starting to go sideways with it.
Here's Oshku after that open frame in the third.
Another ring and 10 on that right lane for Oshku. That's fast. I mean, they leave some of the fastest ringing 10s, those two-handers. I'm gonna rev rate that high. Those are really wickedly fast.
If you're a 10 pin today, you're going to develop a complex.
Well, you're going to get hurt too because the spare ball's coming at you faster.
Got things flying in your face.
And they're throwing 25 mile an hour spare balls at him.
Yeah, and coming with bad intentions. This guy can haul down a spare ball when he wants to. Here's Rash in the fourth. Nobody has struck in the fourth until now.
Well, here at this World Series of Bowling, Rob, 204 entries featured 52 international players from 16 different countries. You're looking at two of the best. One from Australia.
That man, Jason Belmonte.
And the other from Finland, Oshku Palerma.
Ten pin about to get blasted by Belmo, perhaps here.
Seen a lot of those. Ten pin, ten pin, ten pin. Sean Rash did get a strike in the fourth frame. The only guy throwing it with one hand. Go figure.
Oshku, only one strike, came in the first. There's number two as the seven pin got tomahawk from up above. Belmo for the second straight frame. Going after the 10 pin to get the spare, and he takes it. Takes it down.
Well, this is where Belmo's playing now, but last game he was going right around third arrow out to the sixth board. So you can see what a huge difference and a big adjustment, big jump left that he's made. So far, so good.
We move over to Sean Rash. Sean's wife watching, and Sean in second. The low man, Palerma, through five. Low score eliminated. Jason Belmonte, your one seed. Strike number three for Belmo.
Starting to look like maybe possibly a Belmonte Rash showdown.
Those two have had a bit of a prickly relationship. Thawing somewhat.
That was last summer. Rash becoming upset when he thought Belmo intentionally crackled a water bottle during his throw. Something some other players had previously complained about as well. Belmo apologized. The hard feelings remained and probably to some extent still do here today. Here's Palermo in the fifth. Godoskou's far from out. He's got a double.
Yeah, and he's just made another adjustment as well, and he's not that far behind.
So Sean Rash steps up in the sixth. Three in a row. Our thanks to Mike Moniak, the director of bowling here at South Point. He and his crew always put on a good show. Very hospitable, wonderful surroundings here.
Mike's a great guy. I've known him for a long time. He takes real good care of us. Thank you, Mike.
Double wood. Good break there for Belmo.
Yeah, huge break getting the 10 out. Let's see if Oscu can strike here and stay within six of Rash. Also, another strike here. They get a little closer to Belmonte.
Three in a row.
Wow, the four.
Was that the four pin?
The four pin just got slapped silly.
Man.
Watch this. The four pin's going to get a nasty concussion right there. It gets hit from the side and goes into the sidewall like it was drinking.
Belmo. Nice cleanup.
That's the speed. That's the shot.
Time now for the fast, safe pain relief replay brought to you by the makers of Bayer Advanced Aspirin. And here's Jason dropping the double wood. Let the ball do the work.
Well, it always helps when you have a lot of ball, too.
Rash with Belmo watching.
Don't look now, but Rash and Oscu are getting really, really close to Belmonte. In fact, Rash just went around him. Oscu working on three in a row. He can go around Belmonte right here with another strike. Belmonte now working on a spare eighth frame.
What 2-10.
And just like that.
What is that and how?
He had a tremendous lead. And all of a sudden, guess what?
Oscu on the right lane looking for a hand bone. No.
Well, if Belmonte fails to convert the 2-10, he will now be the lowest score.
Two ten. There's the two and just missed the 10.
Yeah, he's going to break something. There's no doubt in my mind he's going to break something.
Sean Rash stepping up to close out the eighth.
So friggin' good. Oh.
10 pin shy, five in a row.
God, that was so friggin' good.
Well, at least he used better grammar that time.
It's nice when we don't have to use the mute button on Sean.
Right. And he made the 10 pin, so yeah, it's all good.
It gets plenty of use when he's up anyways.
Kids, you can still face the television.
So Sean takes a seat. Belmo with a 155. He is in last place and on the verge of getting eliminated. Two frames to make up some territory. Trails Oscu by seven. Rasher leader.
That will help make up some territory.
Good shot, mate.
Remember the last two shots prior to that strike? Light, light, 210, 2810. The adjustment for Belmonte, I think, is just a speed issue.
Fifth strike for the Finnish international.
And the two-handers playing the lanes completely different, Rob. Belmonte's way in, circling, slower speed. Oskou's farther to the right, faster speed. And Rash kind of stuck somewhere in the middle.
So strikes across the board in the ninth.
Belmonte can strike out and shoot 215. Oskou can strike out and shoot 222. Rash can strike out and shoot 238. I think this is must strike time for Belmo.
There's number one. Oskou off a strike.
Gotta have it. That's an awful break. Belmonte, 9 spare, gives him 204. The best player can shoot now 202. If Rash goes 9 out, he shoots 206.
Second effort in the 10th for Jason.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Oskou spare here. Belmonte, let's give him the 3-6-9-10. Palermo can strike on his fill shot and snap Belmonte off by one.
And that's giving Belmo that spare conversion.
Correct.
Oskou misses!
You want to talk about back and forth seesawing. Sean Rash is moving on. Belmonte is moving on.
And Oskou is out of the picture, literally. Fiance, oh, does the look tell it all? You don't need to know what her hubby-to-be just did. Belmo, open frame. Rash keeping things going.
Wow, was it just me or was that bizarre? What a crazy finish.
That's why you bowl all 10 frames. Anybody want to talk to Oskou right now? Anybody at all?
Not me.
Not me. I mean, the breeze almost knocked it down. The flip of the hands. The final is set. Jason Belmonte, your one seed. Sean Rash, your three seed. Title match of the PBA Chameleon Open from Vegas when we return. We are set now for our championship match, Oskou Palermo. Tragic ending for the Finnish international. Jason Belmonte, your one seed, will take on Sean Rash, your 30 seed, and the two of them standing by on the lanes with Randy.
Thanks, Rob. And Jason, I'll start with you. What a bizarre ending to a really crazy match. You made a big adjustment, and then you lost it late in that match when you started going light. What happened?
Yeah, I started to throw the ball a little quick, I was flat 10-in, so I wanted to slow my speed down. And then when I felt like if I slew down too much, slew, is that a word? I don't know. But
it is now.
It is now. I was kind of worried of that 3-6, 9-10 earlier in the match, so I started to gas on it a little bit, and I just wasn't throwing good shots. But the 11th was, it was where I wanted it at the arrows. It wasn't where I wanted it down the lane, and I was kind of hoping for 7, but I ended up getting 6. And then to see Oscar miss the 10-pin, make the most of it now, I think is the best way to go about it.
Good luck in the title match. Thank you. Sean, I'll ask you the same thing. Again, a bizarre match, except for you. You looked like you were in cruise control, and you, too, made a big move. You jumped into the middle part of the lane and kind of showed the two-handers that you have a lot of game. What's the tactic? What's the game plan for the title match?
Well, the title match is the title match. You can only focus on yourself. You can't worry about your competitor. That match there, all three of us have high rev rates, and we know that we were just chasing each other. And I made a great decision there after the first shot there in the game. And I'm just going to go out there and bowl the best I can bowl and hopefully bring home the W.
Thanks, Sean. Good luck.
Rash and Belmo met in the season opener at the World Bowling Tour Finals. It was won by Rash. The rematch in Vegas when we return. Welcome back to our coverage of the PBA World Series of Bowling from Las Vegas' South Point Casino and Exhibition Hall. The finals of the Chameleon Open about to go down. Here now, today's keys to victory, brought to you by the makers of Alka-Seltzer Plus Liquid Gels.
The key for Sean Rash is simple. He needs to take some time. Don't rush one shot throughout this entire match. For Jason Belmonte, he needs to find a better ball reaction, quite simply. Looked like he had something, but it also looked like if he got a little faster, a little slow, it was lighter through the nose.
Impressive that this is Rash's fourth consecutive appearance in a Chameleon telecast, but
count,
what has transpired under the lights has been downright ugly. Rash eliminated in the semifinals 2 years ago because of mistakes like this. And then last year, open frames in the 7th, and then in the 8th, killed any chance he may have had. But to be fair, no one was probably going to beat Scott Norton that day. All strikes for Norton through the first 8 frames. A tough go here on Chameleon, but Rash claims he's learned from his mistakes.
The hardest thing about sports, whether it's bowling, golf, mostly individual sports, is you learn more from failure than winning. And, Brian Voss made a comment a few years ago as he's bowled 600 and something events, and he's only won 24 times. And you look at some of the game's greatest with Walter Ray, Chris Barnes, you can use Dick, Don Carter. I mean, you can use all of them. They lost a lot more than they won. And you try to look at some of the things you did right and move forward to the next week or the next event, next TV show, and try to build off of it.
Sean Rash, your 3 seed. Will bat leadoff in the title match. This close to a dream matchup right now. Two of the real big rising stars in the PBA. Great start. And Sean is going to go back.
None.
And lecture the bar. He is all business in the title match, taking security control under his wing. Belmo.
6-10.
It's going to make that spare a little bit easier. Just a 6-10 now.
Well, it's a nice break. That much power going through the nose. Boy, you would think that a player like Jason Belmonte would split a lot more, but only leaving the 6-10, I think, is a nice break.
And I see Sean Rash in the background worrying about himself, not his competitor.
Again?
A bit of a scrappy pickup there by Belmont. I don't think he had a whole lot of confidence in that one.
Thought he was going to chop the 6-10 again. So again, you know, what is the correct adjustment for Jason Belmont? He just went high. Now, if he uses the same piece of equipment and throws it faster and it pushes and goes too long and he leaves a 2-10 or a 2-8-10 or a 2-8, he's got to make a big change, and I think it would be a ball change. Are you with me on that?
That was picture perfect on the left.
So now he'll make an adjustment on the right lane. He'll move in. He'll try to create some more angle. And if it makes it to the pocket, great. If it goes light, guess what? Just a pinch fast. This ball pushes down the lane just a little bit too long, leaving a soft 10. Got a feeling this is just going to be kind of back and forth, you know, and it's the player that stays ahead of the moves.
Oh, God.
The one who avoids the mistake, and there's your mistake.
And I couldn't get that out fast enough. And there you go. You know, back to the keys. You just heard Sean say it. Take your time. It really is a shame. You want to get beat when you give somebody your best, not when you're missing single pin spares.
A lot of time to make up for that, though. We begin the third.
Oh. Look out. There's anxiety everywhere. Yes. She's feeling it.
Yep. Sarah, his wife, has seen this before here at the World Series of Bowling. He gets himself in position to win, and then something goes wrong. Again, very early, though, in our title match.
That one.
Took his time, stayed under control, and was a lot more accurate with that delivery.
No interaction between those two. Again, go back to really the summer of 2011, and to call that relationship frosty probably would have been warm and cuddly and puppy dogs and cupcakes.
Yeah, it hasn't been good since then.
Belmo, big strike. Well, he knows Rash has given him an opening, and he responds with a strike.
We're going to get some air time here. Watch this. He's so far left now that he's got to loft it over the left gutter cap. Blue is the last shot, so you can see that he's already moved again on that left lane, but he really gave it the business that time, opened up that right lane.
This place is deathly quiet as we begin the fourth.
Real calm demeanor, taking advantage of that open frame. No time to hoop it up just yet. Haven't won yet. Plenty of time for that in the 10th frame. I like that demeanor. I really like that calm, collective demeanor.
Rash, strike, open, spare. Here he is in the fourth. And we'll be looking for another spare if he can drop down the four pin. Still just one strike for Sean Rash here in the title match.
The second of four PBA extra frame events begins this Thursday in Columbus, Ohio, and the only place to see exclusive wall-to-wall coverage, including the title match, is on the PBA's online video subscription service, Extra Frame. Monthly and yearly subscriptions are available via the Extra Frame link over at PBA.com. Remember, exclusive live coverage from Columbus begins next Thursday on Extra Frame.
Rash with the strike there in the fifth.
See if this ball reaction holds up for Belmo when he comes up. But I like this shot here from Sean. It looks like he got around the side of that one a little bit more. Watch this ball tip up, and then he gets the correct pin carry. This is where the two hands create a huge advantage, Rob. When they can move in like this, loft the left gutter cap and still throw it with that kind of revolution and speed, it's almost impossible to beat.
Belmo riding that ham bone to a 43-pin lead through five. Some loft and a Yahtzee courtesy of the messenger.
That's just nasty. I mean, this is just nasty. This is from so far the inside part of the lane. And then to have that kind of pin carry, I mean, it's just nasty.
53 pin hole now for Sean Rash.
Oh, God.
And the wheels on the bus have come off.
3, 6, 7, 12. I don't have to help it.
The tendency when you get that deep with one hand is to help it or grab it at the bottom. And that's what Sean did on that shot there.
And once again, Sarah Rash, along with Sean's dad, Gene, helplessly watching as Sean's struggles continue. You know she would love to help if she could, but it's all on Sean.
It's just heartbreaking to, you know, watch him go third, second, third, you know, never getting that first place finish and that win. And I know he wants it so bad that sometimes he tries too hard, his feet get a little fast, and you know, he just wants it so bad, and I want it for him. I want to see him win again.
And we all do. But barring a miracle, today will not be that day for Sean Rash. Okay. Sean didn't even see that strike, Randy. His head was down, working on his footing.
Well, he's getting dirt thrown on him right now, Rob. And Belmonte is just putting on a clinic on how to play sixth arrow. Looking at the computer-aided tracking system provided by Kegel, the official training center of the PBA, his last shot, Jason Belmonte's ball position, was on the 30th board. Remember, there are only 39 boards on the lane.
Think he's got it figured out?
Well, I think he's really good at lofting the left gutter cap. The amount of side roll and revolutions that he can put on it with two hands, Oscu does the same thing. It's almost unfair. And, you know, there's no rules that say you have to put your thumb in it or you have to throw it with only one hand. When these guys, these two-handed players, players with no thumb, when they can get in and loft sixth arrow, loft the gutter cap, they are really hard to beat.
Seven in a row.
Yes.
Sean with a strike there in the eighth to match Belmo's, but the lead at 77. Doesn't look like things are going to work out for Sean today, but he'll get yet another chance next week. It'll be his fourth appearance in a final here at the World Series of Bowling. It's the PBA Scorpion Open. Sean will take on Patrick Allen, Dave Watka, and Eurostar Dom Barrett. And
Sean finally get it done? Find out next week, 3 Eastern, right here on ESPN. Rash getting another strike there. Bottom of the ninth, Belmo in cruise control.
He can strike out for 290. The best Sean Rash can shoot is 213. Again, just watching this is just amazing. And I mean, to watch somebody play that deep with that much power and accuracy is really spectacular.
This is a beatdown. 8 in a row. And he holds the form.
I mean, he's posting up every shot, too. It's not like he's out of control doing this. This guy is as steady at the foul line as you could get. Watch this. All right, so it's, I mean, he's making it look like that ball weighs about 3 pounds. Look at that position. I mean, he never flinches. He never moves until all 10 pins are in the pit. And quite honestly, the last 7 shots have looked like that.
You know, this one means just a little bit more for Belmo. Than any old title.
Well, that's an old-fashioned.
Yeah. Thank you, everyone. World Series
of all. It's an old-fashioned beatdown.
A beatdown against your chief rival as well. Sean Rash, we've seen that look from him here at the World Series of Bowling. So close. Such a great effort to get to so many shows.
Thank you, Bill Chrisman. Thank you, Stahl.
The stewing continues. You know, you get the sense he's still trying to tinker with that mental game. Let's adjust something here because it didn't work a couple weeks ago. Let's try this. And it kind of had the tone set with that open frame in the second, and Belmo pounced on that opportunity and just ripped off strike after strike after strike.
Thank you, Ron Hoppe, DeAndre Asbadi.
A dominating and thorough performance for Jason Belmonte. Strike a pose. That's the pose of a champion. We'll hear from the Chameleon Open titleist, Jason Belmonte, when we return. The PBA Chameleon Championship is brought to you by Bayer. Try Bayer Advanced Aspirin, extra strength pain relief twice as fast as before. By the USBC and its 2 million members. To find out more about USBC, log on to bowl.com today. By DB8, we are DB8. Tonight, we bowl. And Atonic, power up your game.
This is for everyone back home as well. I love you guys.
Jason Belmonte gets the trophy here at the PBA Chameleon Open, and like all the winners here
Thank
at the World
so
Series
much,
of Bowling,
yes.
He will be seated Woo! Directly into match play at the season-ending Tournament of Champions.
I'm so proud, so happy.
Time now for our GEICO Championship recap. The Eliminator got fired up when it sent Ildemaro Ruiz Jr. to the showers early. Match number 2, Oscu Palermo in the 10th, airmails it, allowing Jason Belmonte to sneak into the title match versus Sean Rash. And in the championship match, Rash, problems, open frame in the 2nd and the 6th. Jason Belmonte, foot on the accelerator, striking in the 2nd all the way through the 9th frames, a route, 268, 191. Belmo, standing by with Randy.
You make playing the 6 arrow look awfully easy. Talk about the adjustment you made in the title match.
Yeah, I was in between bowling balls. I didn't know really what to do, and we took a bit of a risk. Del Ballard and Chris Schlemmer and I, we picked up a ball that I've had some success in the building before, so I just decided if it hooked, just keep going further left until it stopped hooking. And, you know, from the second frame all the way through the 10th, it might have been one of the best games I've bowled. I was so solid and so relaxed and so focused. And I have to thank Ron Hoppy and Deandra Asbadi at the International Art of Bowling for that. They've helped me so much through all this.
So given the little bit of a rivalry that you have with Sean, describe what this win means to you.
Look, it could have been Sean. It could have been Bill O'Neill, Mike Fagan. It didn't matter. I'm here to win. I'm here to beat all these guys and to walk away with the title. My heart's pumping a million miles an hour. I'm so happy. I can't wait to go home and share this with my family who have supported me like no one else. So I'm so happy. And again, I just want to thank everybody, including my sponsors, Storm, Turbo, and Dexter. It's been a fun ride, Randy. I'm having so much fun.
Thanks, Jason. Cheers. Congrats.
There's Sean Rash making another championship game, but unable to take away the hardware. He'll have a chance next week, the Scorpion Open, Sunday, 3 Eastern on ESPN. But it was Jason Belmonte's day. He snuck in match number 2 and absolutely dominated the title match. For Randy Peterson and our entire crew, I'm Rob Stone. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.